It is 5 p.m. in Montrose, Colorado, and this is Distinctive Delphine interviewing Angela Letbean today from the Center for Mental Health here in Montrose, Colorado. Angela and I have been working on a homeless project that I would love for her to share with you. But first, how are you doing? And tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hi, I'm good. My name's Angela Bean, and like she said, I'm with the Center for Mental Health. I used to be a case manager there. Now I work with the justice-based program, but I'm working with a team to help out getting supplies to the homeless, especially during COVID-19. Wanted to reach out and try to get hygiene products and those types of supplies out to people who are in need.
All right, so talking about those supplies, tell me exactly what it is you need and how can we get it to you?
What we are in need of right now is any type of hygiene products, from shampoos, conditioners, bars of soap, deodorants, hand sanitizers, baby wipes or wet wipes, where somebody could clean up themselves if they didn't have water per se. Any type of cleanliness products, toothbrushes, toothpaste types of items. Right now we have a box set up where donations can be dropped off. And that address is 317 South 2nd Street. It's right by the public library. We have a large box set up for donations. And then I pick up and me and hopefully a team or a couple people will stuff those bags. And right now we are working towards like dropping them off at the Cedar Creek Church where they're handing out food. Okay. I'm also leaving them at the Montrose Outpatient Office, the Mental Health Office, and I'm leaving them at the Crisis Walk-In Center.
Okay, great. And I'm typing the address right now, so it will be in the comments for everybody. I've had a lot of comments on these groups on where to drop off. There is also a drop-off area in Telluride. So if you'd like to drop off in Telluride, today is the last day and tomorrow morning, but we will be coming to pick up tomorrow morning. I might be able to pick up weekly, but at this time, if you can drop it off in Telluride at the 8750 gym, that would be phenomenal. I will also stop by Ridgeway tomorrow to pick up, but I will probably only have a couple of pickups. So I'll probably just go to the homes and just pick it up in the driveway tomorrow as well. So that's amazing. And then tell me a little bit more. I think you mentioned masks as well. You might need more masks, so are you good there?
Yes. I am actually working on getting masks out to this population as well. I'd like to supply some masks for this homeless population so that they can protect themselves as well as protect themselves from others if they happen to be carriers. And we want to be able to supply the same services to everybody and protection.
And then a little bit more also, I know that you're working because what you do is amazing, by the way. Thank you for everything that you do.
Thank you.
And Amy and everybody at the Center for Mental Health. It's amazing what you achieve in such little time. So kudos for that. It's awesome.
Thank you.
And talking about that, tell me a little bit more about the program. If I'm homeless and I want to take a shower because Meta is closed at the moment, what do I do? Where do I go? How do I know what's going on?
You could contact myself or Amy. And we're both pretty plugged into this program. What we're doing right now is we're trying to reach out and figure out who needs what. Mm-hmm. So please feel free to reach out to me at the Center for Mental Health. You can call the direct line or you can call my line. And that's where I would have hygiene bags and be able to link you up into other services and programs we have going on right now.
Great, and I'll tag them here too, so everybody knows.
That would be great.
Yes, absolutely, and we're gonna try to have someone from the Center for Mental Health here every week, just because we know how important it is. We wanna talk about anxiety next week, and maybe substance use.
Okay.
So we're really excited to have you in town. You've made so many efforts to let yourself known. And I personally so appreciate that because there's so many people who need help right now. and it's just a stressful time and uncertain time. So I love that you're keeping so much positivity in the community right now. And so tell me just more, what do you think we can do to help the community, the homeless community, but also in general? I really want more tools for everyone. If I want to see someone who's homeless, is it better to send them your way or to help them directly? I know that a lot of people wonder that sometimes.
You know, and that's all personal discretion. A lot of times, I think if we continue to help and give out the right positive information, give out information that I'm providing, even just say, hey, I know at the center, they have people that can really link you up with services. And Cedar Creek Church is really amazing to kind of be a good resource to say, hey, I know where you can get a meal. Those are always really good. Say, Amy's also an excellent resource on getting people linked up with the services that they need right now.
That is awesome. And so they can reach both of you at the Center for Mental Health, correct?
Amy's with Tri-County, but you can definitely reach me, and I know how to get Amy as well.
Okay, awesome. And I just want to highlight that because I feel that sometimes, you know, you feel so alone when you're in that situation, and it's so difficult to know where to look and where to find it, because you found yourself there at the first place you probably didn't expect it. So I really appreciate your time. If you have some last words of wisdom, please let us know, because we'd like to share it with everyone in Montrose.
I would tell everybody to continue to breathe, continue to know that people are out there to help you and support you. You're not alone in this. There are so many resources out there. Just call us if you need us. We have a warm line right now at the Center for Mental Health. You can call directly and get information for resources. We have the crisis line as well. So please don't hesitate to reach out for support.
Sounds good. Even my cat wants to help. You heard it, everyone. Please drop off your donations at 317 South 2nd Street in Montrose. We are trying, Angela and her team are trying to do this weekly for the homeless. So we have some care packages now, but we need more for next week. So please, anything you can do, anything you can share, anything that you collected from the hotels over the years and never used, just hand it over. We'd love to use it. And if you have any questions, yes, you can come to me, you can come to Angela at the Center for Mental Health. Thanks again, everyone, for listening. And hopefully this was valuable and helpful to you today. Thanks so much, Angela.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.